All right, meanwhile, everyone, Donald Trump is coming out with his plan to overhaul the U.S. tax system. And guess what? He's not going to let those hedgies, those hedge fund guys, call their income investments. Because you know what? If they call it investment, they get a way better deal on taxes. So you know what? He's going to make sure, he says, that they're going to pay up just like everyone else. Watch this.
Nobody knows the tax code better than I do, okay? I know it better. I'm the king of the tax code. And I'm going to come out with a plan, a simplification, a plan, getting rid of some of the deductions, which are ridiculous and complicated. We are going to simplify the tax code, take away some of the deductions, and hedge fund guys have to pay up. We are destroying the middle class in this country. So I will have a plan. The hedge fund guys won't be happy, but pretty much everybody else is going to love it.
He's the king of the tax code. But you heard him say the hedge fund guys, they're not going to like it. He is going someplace that Hillary just won't dare. You know what? She will not promise to raise taxes on hedge funds because guess what? Those hedge funds, they are the ones that are financing her campaign. Blake Berman is back with us from D.C. with more on Trump's tax plan. So what might we expect when it comes to dealing with hedge funds and private equity investors?
Well, we're starting to get bits and pieces here, Trish, over the last couple of weeks. It appears this tax plan is going to be one of the next, if not the very next, policy proposal that Donald Trump will outline. You'll remember he told Maria Bartiromo last Thursday that his plan is coming within 4 weeks, and he reiterated that today. Trump continues talking about cutting taxes for the middle class, cutting taxes for corporations. They were singled out when Maria pressed him for those specifics last Thursday. Here was that. Take a listen.
Reduction in corporate taxes or all taxes? What?
A reduction in all taxes, but especially corporate and especially for the middle class. I mean, what we're doing to our middle class is inconceivable. It's terrible.
However, as you also mentioned, Trish, Trump since then has begun to target hedge fund managers. He says they're not paying enough tax. The billionaire businessman has even says he would be okay with raising taxes on himself. By the way, according to the Weekly Standard, Trish, Jeb Bush will release his tax plan on September 9th. That's a couple weeks from now. That puts it within the same time frame here as Trump. Trump, as you heard him tell Maria Bartiromo, will happen within the next 4 weeks. It'll be interesting to see now that Jeb Bush has said September 9th, if Trump will put it out before then and try to jump Jeb or put it out after then.
I think it's going to be absolutely, positively fascinating. I'm kind of into things like tax code, so I can't wait to see this. Thank you so much, Blake. Good stuff. Joining me right now is best-selling author Dina Loudon, talk show host Sean Pittman. As we try and think about, Gina, just exactly what might be in this, do you anticipate that it's going to be perhaps a flat tax?
I think that that would be a great choice on his part. I think that resonates with the American public. And I think he's in the most beautiful position of any other candidate, that he is so independent of Wall Street, that he can make these, grandiose statements that he knows aren't going to dry up his donor base, right? And so,
but he doesn't hate them. Yeah.
That's exactly right. And so I wouldn't be surprised. I love that he's using the word simplification, because that terminology is going to resonate with the middle class and the voters, especially on the GOP side.
It's fascinating to me, this sort of return of the flat tax, Sean. We've seen that now several candidates push that forward. Rand Paul, of course, comes to mind. Think people have had it with the 70,000 plus pages of code?
Oh, yeah. And I think, Donald Trump is finally, sounds like he's getting some real political advice now, because he's, in 2011, in his book, he talked about a tax plan that talked about flat tax. It talked about penalizing corporations who send jobs overseas. But now he seems to be talking directly to the middle class and talking to people about simplifying the tax code. Who wouldn't want to simplify it? I mean, have you ever sat down and
I know who
to
doesn't
do
want
taxes?
To simplify it. I know. The accounting firms don't want to simplify
right.
it. They make a lot
absolutely.
Of money off
the
all
accounting
this.
For,
and
the
special
accounting
interest
firms
groups.
Are the only ones that are having a problem here.
Yeah,
but,
and special interests.
Give him credit for that.
I do. I do give him credit for that. And I think it gets back to what Gina was saying earlier. It's kind of nice to see someone out there who is his own man. How long, though, does that really last? At some point, Gina, will he need to pay attention to polling data that says Americans feel this way or that on particular issues?
I think his I think he is such a different candidate from anyone we've ever really seen. And I think really what Americans are enjoying about him is that he doesn't seem to be particularly pandering to the traditional groups that the elite in Washington, D.C. have always said the GOP candidates need to compromise with and pander to. So I don't really foresee him, you know, being one of those that licks his finger and sticks it in the air to see what the voters think. I think he's been listening a long time. Mm-hmm. I think he's saying the things the voters want to say, want to hear. And I also think he's doing this really smart thing, this teaming up with Cruz thing that has the attention captivated just when we thought we might run out of what's interesting about Trump.
Yeah, they're going to have that rally together to protest the Iran deal. Sean, before we go, has there ever been a candidate quite like him in history? I mean, I think in modern history, to me anyway, Ross Perot may be the guy that comes to mind. But, I mean, anyone that has embodied this sort of, you know, I don't care what they think attitude to the extent that he does?
Sure. But what we're dealing with is not really the candidate. What we're dealing with is America. America has changed. I mean, people hear him. I mean, look at the other candidates that are trying to be Trump. I mean, it's not working for them. Trump is being exactly who he is. The numbers, there's still more people voting for who want to vote for other people than Trump. But it's working because the American population has gotten fed up with politicians in general.
Yeah. I had to hand it to him yesterday. I mean, it was hysterical to watch the whole hair thing. You saw him trying to prove that, you know, it's not a toupee. And he brought someone up from the audience. I was kind of wondering why she didn't grab it a little harder, though, because, you know, everybody's still kind of wondering. Anyway, Tina, Sean, thank you so much. Good to have
you
guys
here. Thanks for
having us. All right, breaking news, everyone. We've got you.